Hi, welcome everyone. As the launch of train services of the Lagos Blue Line and the Lagos Red Line inches closer, the Lagos State Governor Sanwo-Olu and his team toured the Blue Line project to see how the work is going on and the level the construction has reached, which is now put at 90% completion. They even took a train ride, but we will see that in a moment. Electric trains will be running on the Lagos Blue Line and construction is expected to be completed by the end of this year. And testing and other finishing touches will ultimately culminate in train services starting in the first quarter of 2023. There are still sections not yet completed along the Blue Line, which will take a few months to finish. There are interchanges like this one in Suru Alaba with a link bridge to Second Rainbow, which will reduce traffic around Mile 2. Having alternative roads are great because not everyone needs to reach Mile 2 before making a turn, especially those going to Oshodi and Sele bus stop from Orile. There are other uncompleted sections like the interchange in Iyanoba and Lasu, and of course Okoko. And the Blue Line will soon be extended from Okoko to Abara in Ogun State. According to the governor of Ogun State, they have entered into partnership with the Lagos State government to extend the Blue Line from Okokomaiko to Abara in Ogun State. When it's done, it will enable many factories in the massive Abara Industrial Estate to receive and send their containers to Apapa Port. Of course, there will be passenger traffic too. Anyway, the Lagos State government has a word for people who don't use the overhead pedestrian bridges along the Blue Line corridor, because very soon the tracks will be electrified. Let's listen in.
What also happened on the Blue Line is what we call the third rail, right? The third rail is the power, right, that will now be activated on this rail track. The Blue Line, for emphasis, will be running what we call an EMU. It's going to be an electric motor vehicle. The trains are going to be running on electric, right? So they need to have power on the rail tracks. So that's why we're getting to a state where there has to be a lot of advocacy. There has to be a lot of information, communication onto the citizens, especially where the track was on grid from Orile Station up onto Mile 2, you know that it was at grid level, meaning it was at ground level. And if you have a track at ground level, right, that is electric, you've seen that we've wired off all the alignment. But you see, a lot of our citizens that do not know, they've started breaking all of the rules that we've done. We'll go back there and fix it. And there has to be a lot of enforcement, a lot of advocacy. Because by the end of the year, when this track starts, they are electric trucks. They are going to be running on electricity, and you will know that citizens or passengers or anybody whatsoever cannot walk on those things. Right? So, gentlemen of the press, you have that responsibility. From now, we'll begin to mention that for the next 6 months, 8 months, we'll begin to mention that this track is not like the red line. The red line is DMU, but the blue line is EMU. So these are some of the communications that we need to begin to pass out, and they are electric train lines. And
have you subscribed to a channel? If you love what you're seeing, you should subscribe to a channel and enable notification in order to see even more beautiful projects across Nigeria. Thank you for subscribing. The governor also visited the elevated platform of the National Theatre Station. He tested the card payment system for the Lagos Blue Line.
No, step back a bit. Uh-huh. People are seeing it too. Uh-huh. Step back a bit. Step back.
This is the type of payment system that Nigeria Railway Corporation should deploy in many stations along the Lagos-Ibadan Railway, to eliminate ticket racketeering and other things at play. People shouldn't be paying cash at the train stations. This is how it's done. You place your card and the system reads to know if you have enough money to afford the journey. If there's enough money in your card, it lets you through. And when you're leaving the station, it calculates your fee and bills you accordingly. It all depends on how it is programmed. Some systems will actually bill you immediately you place your card. For instance, if the trip from Mile 2 to Marina costs 200 Naira, it will take 100 Naira from your card immediately you enter the station. When you disembark at the Marina station, it takes the remaining. These cards can also be used for shopping in some supermarkets, although it's not clear if they have integrated that yet. But they will eventually, because Oyster cards in the UK can be used in supermarkets, likewise Octopus in Singapore. It's a convenient and safe way of shopping because it's not like your normal bank card where all the money in your account is accessible. This one you can load like 5,000 Naira and that's the only amount that is accessible, with minimum risk if the card is lost. Just like all new technology, Lagosians will adapt quickly as Lagos continues to develop massively. A lot of Nigerian states should copy Lagos state already, especially the oil-rich states that can afford mass transit systems to make transportation easier for workers. It will equally save our roads because if more people use mass transit systems, it will reduce the number of cars on our roads, which ultimately leads to reduction in pollution in our cities. Delta, Rivers, Akwa Ibom, and many other states can afford to build mass transit systems in their states. By the way, Akwa Ibom is building a world-class, smart, and fully automated new airport terminal, one of a kind in Nigeria. You can check out the video we made about it in the video description. Now, let's see the train ride. For those who keep wondering or asking how electric trains will operate efficiently in Lagos because of energy shortages, the Lagos Blue Line electric trains and other associated infrastructure will not depend on the national grid for power supply. The entire Blue Line infrastructure will have its own power plant in Okokomaiko that would be dedicated to the service. And you know what happens when you are in control of your own power supply, the reliability will be assured. That's actually how some electrified trucks operate around the world. They take the power directly from the energy companies to eliminate hiccups. Imagine an electric train going at high speed and it loses power. Also, the reason why the Blue Line doesn't have massive stations like the Red Line is because apart from the sections where it is elevated, that's from Orile to Marina, other sections are in the middle of this 10-lane superhighway, the Lagos Badagry Expressway. So it's difficult to squeeze massive stations in the middle of the highway. Unlike the Red Line, where the tracks are on the side of the road, they are building massive stations that will accommodate the huge Lagos population even in the future. Another video will be coming to update you on happenings along the Red Line, because since the last update we did, a lot of changes has taken place. The whole place is a huge construction site. Alright, let's go back to the section of the Blue Line that will take a while to complete. Construction will ramp up around here and the Marina station. They are already working 7 days a week in order to deliver this massive project. This is actually how it is done. When a contract is awarded, there should be a time limit. And if the contractor defaults and fails to deliver within the stipulated time, he starts paying a fine per day. Because getting funding for projects costs a lot of money, and the government must have calculated how much they stand to lose if the Blue Line trains don't start running at the expected time. As you can see, the Marina station is taking shape, and it is from here that the proposed Lagos Green Line will start. The Lagos State government is not joking about development of the transport infrastructure in Lagos. While the Blue Line and the Red Line are expected to start operations very soon, they are already working on the Green Line that will start from here to Victoria Land, Lekki, Ajah, and all the way to the proposed new airport and Lekki Free Trade Zone. For more information, you can watch the video we made about it. All video links are in the video description. Also, remember to subscribe to our channel and enable notification. Thanks. There's a lot of money in transportation. That's why many private people that go into transportation business doubles their fleet within a short time. This is why government at all levels should go into mass transportation business. so as to bring the needed competition and drive the cost of transportation down. When you consider the average wage of Nigerian workers, most workers spend a substantial amount of their monthly salary on transportation, which is not good for the economy, because the more money people are able to save, the more they are able to spend on other things, and ultimately the economy will be better for it. It also increases people's confidence in the system, because when you work all day and at the end of the month, you don't have any savings. It's very discouraging, you know. The situation pushes a lot of people to do illegal things to make ends meet. So other states should seriously emulate Lagos State and build mass transit systems. Even if it's not railway driven, they can buy extra long buses, and since they carry more people, it will definitely be less expensive compared to the smaller vehicle or tricycles. These kind of buses can offer cheap fares within the city so that people can be on the move all the time, and it will also reduce inflation because high transport fares contributes to high cost of goods and services. Alright, we hope you enjoyed the video. As usual, like the video, subscribe to our channel and enable notification. Till next time, bye bye.